firstly, good afternoon to Meenakshi ma'am and Arwa ma'am, and to Himanshu sir and all my dear friends here. So consider me as your friend and not something who is giving like a session on a particular topic. So we will keep it very interactive so we both can learn from each other. So I will just like to share my screen. Just a second. So all of you guys can see my screen, and am I audible enough?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
thank you so much. So the impact of foreign institutional investors on Sensex and Nifty on the market. So what is an FII? Foreign institutional investors. So any institution who is incorporated outside India, but is keen or is investing in India, in the share markets, is an FII, is the foreign institutional investor. So as quoted by SEBI, you can see any institution established or incorporated outside India which proposes to make investment in India is an FII. So FII is from the start, like from before 1992, India was very stringent on allowing FIIs to invest in India. There are many rules and regulations which restricted the flow of FIIs of foreign inflows in Indian market. But after 1993, after 1992, 1993, it allowed foreign investments to invest in India, particularly in the primary and the secondary capital markets. So what happens is, when there is an FII inflow, when there is an increase in the investment in the foreign institutional investors' investment increase, what happens is the demand for good stocks increase because they have their research. So they do invest in good stocks. So demand for that increases, which paves the way the stock prices of the upward movement, and which paves the way that Sensex and Nifty rises. So it has a direct correlation. The foreign institutional investors has a direct correlation with the Sensex and Nifty. I come to the page 3. Like, who are FIIs? We know it's a foreign entity, but who are they? Like, basically, they are big companies. They are big insurance companies. They are big pension funds. They are big investment banks. They are mutual funds. They are asset management company who are incorporated outside India, but would like to invest in India. So why, like, what is the main reason that FII is investing in India? As our country, as our India is a developing economy, and so they know the growth potential in India, and normally it's a win-win situation for both. Like, India needs FII investment and FII needs to invest in India for their growth as well. So it's a win-win situation for both. So firstly, if you are an FII incorporated outside India, so you have to first register with the SEBI, our market regulator, Security Exchange Board of India. You have to register with SEBI, then only you can start investing in Indian market. So approximately there are around 1400 to 1500, like exact 1450 is the count of foreign institutional investors registered with India in like they are allowed to invest in India. So once the investment starts coming from FII, so we have to put a cap. Like, there are big companies like Infosys who has a great potential. So if we don't put a cap on the investment, so the maximum amount will be done by FII. So what government, RBI and SEBI has decided to put a cap on the investments, maximum investment an FII can do in an Indian, in our market, in our capital market. So what is that number? 24% of the total paid up capital of a company in which they are investing, that is the maximum amount an FII can invest in the market, not more than that. And if it's a bank, it's a public sector bank, the count is 20%. Only 20% of the paid up capital can come from an FII. Other than the rest, 80% should come from the DII or other investments. So what RBI has done, like the Reserve Bank of India, which handles the banking system. So what they have done is, when it crosses the 18% benchmark, we have invested almost 18% of the paid up capital, So they instruct the bank, like only 2% cutoff point is left. So you have to take care that it doesn't cross 20% at any given point of time. So on the cap, RBI and SEBI are very stringent, and that helps the Indian equity market as well. So putting a cap was a perfect move by SEBI and RBI. So that is there. Now, who is the beneficiary? Like, India is the beneficiary with the FII flows coming in. So India has been always a huge beneficiary. And as you guys might be knowing, the last fiscal year, like from 2021, say, our market has grown by 70 to 80%. Like, it has almost doubled the numbers. So why was that? So as you can see the numbers here, the broader market also participated and outperformed frontline indices. The Nifty mid cap and the Nifty small cap gave 101 and 124% respectively in the fiscal year 2020. And average Nifty gave a 70% return. So why was that? So it was FII driven market, because FII was strongly investing at the time of COVID, while our domestic investors were booking profit because there were no liquidity for us to invest more. So why are FII buying more and more and more in India? So what is the particular reason? There might be a particular reason, right? So as our country, like India, is dynamically growing and is a growing economy, so it's a perfect investment place for FII to invest their funds. And it also has growth potential, like growing potential. India has growing potential in the coming years, and it is 100% going to give the return they are assuming that we should get. And also our economy is growing and growing in a way, like it will give returns to that them as well. Also because of the weak dollar index. Now the dollar index, what we call, is becoming weak day by day, not that much weak in compared to our rupee, but it is comparatively going weak day by day as our rupee is increasing. So also we are upfront on the vaccine progress. We have almost, we are on the third position on the maximum number of vaccines given country-wise. So these are the reasons why FII look and are keen to invest in India. Now we will just observe the correlation between Sensex and FII. As you can see a graph, so the blue line shows the FPI monthly investment and the orange line shows the Nifty. So as you can see, jo month mein FPI investment is coming down, our Nifty is also coming down a bit. And when there is a higher amount of FPI investment, our Nifty is growing. So last year was like it was FII driven market. Because as you can see, 2016 se leke 2020 tak ka, this is the graph. So you can see there is a direct correlation, but there are many other factors as well which drive the market. So now we will see ki FII flows in India with respect to Nifty 50 return, and from 2011 to 2020, what was the purchase and what was the sale. So in 2011, almost minus 26,000 was the net purchase, net sales in crore. So you can see Nifty 50 return was minus 24%. In 2012, 2014 and 2017, the net purchase was good. Like almost FII bought 1 lakh crore of investment in India. So the Nifty grew by 27%. So it has a particular relation. You will not find a particular pattern ki itna investment aaya to Nifty grow ho gaya. There is no particular pattern, but if you can observe ki it supports the market. It is not only the driving force, but it supports the market. Data suggests that ki if there is an ample amount of investment from FII, Nifty is going to grow. There is no doubts about that. So many people have doubt ki FDI hai, foreign direct investment, and this is FII, foreign institutional investor. So is there any difference? Like dono bar se hi aa raha hai, funds are coming from outside to India. So is there any particular difference? Yes, there is a particular difference. like FII, foreign institutional investors, come in for trading. They invest the money for short period of time. They take the money out in a year or two. Like the long term investment is lower, on a lower side. While FDI, they invest. FDI means foreign direct investment. The investment is coming from outside, but they stay here for longer term, and they invest in companies which have. They also get some what we call direct production activity. They are involved in the direct production activity, and the FDI company, which the company is investing, they get a degree of control in the company as well as they are investing. While FII doesn't get any degree of control in the company, they are just investing the money. So FDI brings long-term capital, while FII, foreign institutional investors, bring short-term capital. So we all know 2020 and 2021, the year of adversities. Like at the time of COVID crisis, many things are going wrong, many things are going right as well in coming future because of all the vaccine we are taking. In future, it's going to be like on a good time. But at the time of COVID, India gets highest ever FII inflows of 37.6 million in a financial year of 21. Like the maximum investment came from outside because they knew this is the time of crisis. We can invest and we can take the money when market is on back on track. So they know when to invest, when not to. So they are the research is perfect. Like at what time we should invest. And if you can observe Nifty 50, mein we have 50 companies. Nifty 50 is a Sensex, jiska 50 companies hai. Usme 2021 mein 49 companies gave almost best return they could. Only one company, Coal India, as you can see, was minus 7% only, which ended lower. Rest all gave positive returns. So because of FII and many other things going on, because of their performance as well, we just can't say that FII inflow are hai, toh their stock price is increasing. We can't say that. But it plays a very huge role in the increase and decrease of the value of the stock. So we come to the preferred companies. Ki abhi tak what we have observed, ki FII invest in preferred companies. Ki yahi companies mein we will invest. Because they know the potential of that company. They have their research and that. So as you can see, some of the prominent firms where FII increased their stake phenomenally include Mishra Dhatu Nigam, up 5,700% from last year. AstraZeneca Pharma, India, 382% from last year have increased. The value of the share has increased from last year by 382%, almost 400%. Why was that? Because pharma was already is a boom right now. And also FII investment where they were investing heavily. And also the L&T Technology Services, AU Small Finance Bank, Aster DM Healthcare, RT Industry. These were the firms like FII invested heavily. So you will observe that there is not a particular sector FII is investing. This sector, they invest in every sector. Like not a particular sector, ki pharma is growing, so we will invest in pharma. No, we will invest in every sector so that their risk get reduced and they are able to make more profits. Also, companies where FII holding has increased over 50% was Bata India, Endurance Technology, Coal India. So particularly they had invested heavily in this preferred companies. These were the preferred companies by FII. These are the seven stocks with highest FII shareholding. So what you can learn from this? So these stocks are perfect stocks because they have the FIIs have their own research. Without their research, they won't invest so much heavily in this stock. First is HDFC. Second, you can see Shriram Transport. Third, you can see Z Entertainment, Apollo Hospitals, Axis Bank, IndusInd Bank, ICICI Bank. So there are many banks, as you can see, because everyone knows the banking sector and pharma sector are going to be a boom in the future. So yeah. So now we will see we saw the FII, foreign institutional investors, what was the role. Now we will, you guys can ask questions if you want. I'm just left with two slides. Then we will do the question answer round and we will interact. So FII versus DII. What is DII? DII is domestic institutional investor. FII is foreign institutional investors. So the companies incorporated in India, investing in India, are DII, domestic institutional investors. But what is the difference between them? Like as we mentioned before, FII invest for a short period of time. They book their profits and they go away. Like they are not a long-term investor. But DII normally are long-term investors. Because they are from our country, India. So they think long-term. They are mostly long-term investors. And comparatively, FII has a good research team and good research than our domestic institutional investors. So that is the difference. And as we mentioned before, there are no restrictions on DII because domestic institutional investors, we can invest the maximum amount in the stock. But FII has a restriction, as I mentioned, 24% and 20% for banks. So that is the restrictions. So that is the difference between a foreign institutional investor and a domestic institutional investor. So both are very important for our country and both are like we call a vital role in Sensex and Nifty. So financial year 21 was a year of huge volatility. Everyone knows that. Now the markets are more stable and mature. So slowly, but will be positive in the long term in coming 3 to 4 years. So it is said that financial year 21 was the year of FIIs and financial year 2022 will be the year of DIIs. So maximum after the positive results of the company, DIIs are going to also invest heavily in our markets. So that is what is written. Talking about DIIs, I suggest they might be more aggressive in the financial year 2022. Reports are suggesting that. So what is the conclusion of the whole thing, what we discussed, FII, DII, impact kya hai market pe, how is Sensex and Nifty calculated based on the FII inflows in the market? What is the conclusion? What we learn from all this? So what we learn is, both FII and DII are very important for economic and retail investors. Retail investors, they are more important because what retail investors do is they check the FII inflows. Kitna aa raha hai ye month mein, what is the FII inflow? They check that and according to that, they invest because that has become a now new rule. After doing all your research, you have to check this as well. FII kitna investment aa raha hai for this particular month or this particular fortnight. So that research is also there, ki FII's inflows, how much we are coming. However, after all looking at their data, retail investors should do their own research before buying any stock for long term, for short or for short term. So that should be a key factor while doing your research. So that's all from my side. Now you can shoot up questions and we can like take things forward from there.
I guess part that was really interesting and deep. And I think 5,700% returns is really huge. Also, a lot of people ask me ke COVID ka time hai, employment itna hai nahi, but phir bhi Indian markets itna high kyu ja raha hai. In fact, aaj bhi kafi high hai. तो उसका वन ऑफ द फैक्टर इज एफ आई आई इनफ्लोज. अगर आप मनी कंट्रोल एप्स ये सब देखते हो तो आप नोटिस करोगे कि काफी सारा पैसा इंडियन मार्केट्स के अंदर आ रहा है. हमारे डोमेस्टिक इन्वेस्टर्स इतने इन्वेस्ट नहीं करते हैं स्टॉक मार्केट्स के अंदर, हार्डली कुछ परसेंट है. ओके, बट बाहर से पैसा काफी आता है, मेनली बिकॉज आई गेस बाहर के लोग ज्यादा ट्रस्ट करते हैं इंडियन इकोनॉमी को राजर देन इंडियन पीपल देमसेल्व्स.
Yeah.
हम इंडियन इन्वेस्टर्स को बोलते हैं पैसा इन्वेस्ट करने, तो उनको डर लगता है कि भाई पैसे डूब जाएंगे, बट बाहर के लोग इतने लैक्स ऑफ करोड़ ऑफ रुपीस डालते हैं. सो आई गेस इट इज अ टाइम फॉर इंडियन इन्वेस्टर्स ऑल्सो टू बी नॉट टोटली डिपेंडेंट ऑन एफ आई आई इनफ्लोज. कि अगर कोई ईयर में अगर एफ आई आई नहीं आया तो भी ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि हमारे मार्केट्स नेगेटिव रिटर्न्स दे. ओके, So let's take on the questions. I guess group one, group leader is Disha. Disha, you're there?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Hi, Disha.
Anyone from your group wants to ask anything, interact anything on this particular topic, or what do you feel about FII impact on Sensex and Nifty? Shloka, Disha, Pratiksha, Pallavi, Sania, Madhvi, Akansha, Tanvi, Arya. We have 5 more minutes and then we will move to Charmi Gandhi.
Any questions like to the whole session was going on, you might be having a kuch to question hoga. You can
come on, guys. आप सबके डीमैट अकाउंट है यहाँ पे 10 लोग है आपके ग्रुप में. आई गेस जूम पे सब बंद करके कोई क्या कर रहा पता नहीं.
हेलो गर्ल्स, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस टू आस्क?
सर, प्रतीक्षा हैज वन क्वेश्चन. शी हैज रिटन, हाउ डज FII अफेक्ट्स द स्टॉक मार्केट?
Net purchase, net sale amount in crores. That can affect the market in short term, in long term as well. So you can say that FIIs have a very important role currently in India, because as sir mentioned like 2 minutes back, like that domestic investors are not investing so much. So we are dependent, like not totally dependent, but we are dependent on FII for the what we call the rise and the fall of the stocks. So it has a very important role, and like investing pattern of FIIs have a very important role in determining the impact of Sensex and Nifty.
Okay, one more question has come from Komal. Is why FII does not invest for long term but for medium term?
That's a good question, I must say. Why does FII not invest for long term? Because they are looking at any point of time, they are looking to book profits, because they are here to make profits. They are not here to make investment in India and grow. Like, they don't want India to grow, or they don't have such dreams. They just have their dream ki invest karenge, profit book karenge, and we will increase. We will, like, they will grow. They don't have dream to make India big or something, because they are foreign institutional investors. So they are like, it has been observed, they are being there for short terms, maximum for 5 to 7 years. The long term FII are very rare. So that is the case. So we can't help, but they are here for short term. They book their profits and they go.
Correct. वो पैसा बनाने के लिए आते हैं. उनको इंडिया के ग्रोथ स्टोरी में इतना इंटरेस्ट नहीं होता है. FDIs जो आते हैं वो लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए आते हैं. FIIs बहुत शॉर्ट टर्म के लिए आते हैं. So one last question and then we will move to Charmi. The question is के one second.
Yeah.
So my question is that you say FII allow in India is only 20%. So how it have a great impact? Yeah. Parth, would you like to answer?
Yes. Good question again. 20% in a particular firm, in a particular company, 20% not of the whole market. So what they do is FII, if you can see, it's 24%. In banks, it's 20%. So as you can see, the maximum, the 24% share is in the hands of FII. Rest is for the domestic institutional investors. But 24% share, they invest heavily on a single day or in a single month. So that affects what you can say, the working of that month. So you can assume from that ki itna FII investment aaya ye month mein, but phir bhi there was a like huge impact on the Sensex and Nifty. Ye kyun hua? Because 24% se fat se 16% ho gaya, fat se 12 ho gaya, fir wapis 24 ho gaya. So they invest heavily but book profits heavily. So that can affect the market routine, and thus it affects and impacts the whole Sensex and Nifty.
करेक्ट, वेरी वेल सेड पार्थ, बिकॉज अगर आप लोग नोटिस करोगे तो पेंडेमिक के टाइम पे शायद चाइनीज फर्म्स वर मेकिंग ह्यूज इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इन आई गेस HDFC बैंक, एंड वो टाइम पे रेस्ट्रिक्शंस भी लगाया था, बिकॉज अगर कैपिंग नहीं रहेगा एंड अगर कोई एक कंपनी या एक इकोनॉमी दूसरे कंपनी के अंदर बहुत हैवी इन्वेस्टमेंट्स कर रही है एंड सडनली वहां से सेल ऑफ करके निकल रही है तो वो स्टॉक काफी गिरेगा, उसको देख के बाकी स्टॉक्स भी गिरेंगे, तो वो कैपिंग काफी जरूरी हो जाती है एंड दैट इज अ वेरी गुड मूव बाय सेबी. ओके,